Yeah, good morning everybody. Welcome back to the continuation of moment distribution method chapter of structural analysis 2. Now we dealt few typical problems to analyze using moment distribution method. It is only continuous beams. Now coming to the next is this portal frames. Continuous beams are beams which contains number of members and all are horizontals. Now a frame is a structure having both horizontal and vertical members, such as usually horizontal members in civil engineering structure will be called as beams and vertical members will be called as column. If a structure consisting of both horizontal and vertical frames or vertical portions like this are called, that is, beams and columns are called frames. The joint between any two members, here we are seen in the assumptions, the joint between any two members or more members is assumed to rotate as a whole. I have illustrated that. That means angle between these two remains same even after the rotation. There is no joint rotation, and hence these are also called rigid frame. And if beams and frames are perpendicular to each other like this in all the cases, and they are called orthogonal frames. If you take portal frames or rigid frames, or because of the assumption that orthogonal frames, there are two types of frames. One is non-sway frames. Non-sway frames are the frames which do not sway, or there is no lateral displacement, and are called non-sway frames. For example, if you take this combination of beams and columns, here whatever may be the loading, because of this fixity and this fixity, the frame will not sway to the right side or to the left side. No sway or no lateral displacement, and they are called non-sway frames. Or it may be this situation need not be always fixed. It may be a roller or hinged support like this. If it is subjected to some external loads, there is no sway or lateral movement here also to the right side or to the left side. No movement, and they are called non-sway frames. Or it may be a simple one like this, subjected to symmetrical loading. Here there is no lateral displacement of the portal frame to the left side or to the right side because of this symmetrical loading. And this is called, these are called Nernst wave frames. Now, coming to the sway frames, the second one are sway frames. If there is lateral displacement of the portal frames, they are called sway frames. In sway frames, this lateral displacement or sway may occur due to few reasons. One is unsymmetrical loading. For example, if you take this frame, if it is subjected to UDL only for this portion, or a frame subjected to a point load with eccentricity, that means these are different, there is a lateral displacement, or there may be horizontal loading here also there is a sway, that is because of unsymmetrical loading. Now, coming to unsymmetrical geometry, this is unsymmetrical loading. Now, this lateral displacement may occur due to unsymmetrical geometry, that is this case, both may be fixed. Even though it is subjected to symmetrical loading, there is a sway because of the geometry, and this is unsymmetrical geometry. Now, it may be because of non-uniform section, nothing but if they have different cross sections. In other words, if it is 2i, if it is i, and if it is i, that is moment of inertias are different, then it is non-uniform section. Or it may be due to horizontal loading. This is here. Horizontal loading. That is nothing but unsymmetrical loading. Now, maybe because of settlement of the supports. It means we have dealt some problem in continuous beams also. In this frame, everything may be symmetrical. Loading may be symmetrical. Section may be the same. But if any one support settles, then also it is sway. That is settlement of supports. These are the few conditions under which the lateral displacement may occur, and it is called, and they are called sway frames or sway portal frames, and the analysis of this will be different. Now we will deal some numerical problems of the analysis of sway frames. This sway frames. We will take problems directly. Hope you understood, dear students. There are two types of frames. That is portal frames. Portal frames are frames which consisting of horizontal members, that is beams, and vertical members, nothing but columns. As it is assumed, the horizontal members and vertical members angle will not change. There is no rotation of the joints. They are also called rigid frames. If you take these rigid frames, two types, non-sway, that is if there is no lateral displacement of the frames. Now we will deal some of numerical problems on this non-sway frames. Now this is the numerical problem. One problem we will take. To analyze the frame shown in figure by moment distribution method. Now this consisting of a beam portion ABC in which AB and BC are the two beams and BD is the vertical member, that is column. AB is subjected to a load of 100 kilonewton and it is asymmetrical loading, and BC is loaded with UDL throughout. Now, because of this fixity here and here there is an hinge support, there is no lateral moment, because even though there is asymmetrical loading and asymmetrical section 2II, because hinge, there is no translation, there may be rotation. No translation means no moment. This hinge and fixed beam, they keep the frame in its original position only. Now, as usual, the first step is assuming the different members in the frame as fixed. That is, AB as one portion, that is fixed beam, BC as one portion, that is fixed beam, and BD as one fixed column and fixed column, but the both the ends, and we will calculate the fixed end moments. Now for the portion AB, fixed end moment now AB, it is assumed as fixed and it is loaded with a point load of magnitude 100 kilonewton at distances 3 and 2. Therefore, MF AB will be minus WAB squared by L squared, that is minus 100 into A is 3, this A, B is 2 square, divided by L is 5 square, and it is minus 72 kilonewton meter. Now MF BA will be plus W A squared B divided by L squared, that is plus W is 100 into A squared, it is 3 squared into 2 divided by L squared is 5 squared, and it is plus 48 kilonewton meter. Oh, this is 2, this is 3 in the given problem. That means this will be 3 squared 2 and this is 3 into 2 squared. Okay. Now the next is the portion BC. BC is subjected to UDL. Intensity is 20 kilonewton per meter. The length of the beam portion BC is 3 meter. Therefore, MFBC will be minus WO L squared divided by 12 if it is UDL. That is minus 20 into 3 squared divided by 12. And it is minus 15 kilonewton meter. Then MFCB will be plus WL squared by 12 and it is plus 15 kilonewton meter. Now we have the next portion. It is a vertical member. It is BD, not subjected to any loads. Therefore, MFBD will be equal to MFDB, that's equal to 0, are the fixed end moments. And they are shown here, the calculation of fixed end moments. Now the next step is calculation of the distribution factor. Now, we have only one joint B. Now, to calculate the distribution factor, we use same table, joint, that is only B, and member connected to joint B. If you refer the original figure, it is BA, BC, and BD. Now, if you calculate K, see BA here. BA, edge support is fixed. Edge support is fixed. Therefore, stiffness of the member BA, we know it is 4EI by L. And here, 4E into I is 2I. That is 2I divided by L. The length of member BC is 5. Coming to BC, BC, it is far end or edge support is hinged. Therefore, stiffness of the member BC, if it is edge end, it is 3EI by L. And moment of inertia of the member BC is I only. This. And L is 3 meter. You can see that here. This is 3 meter. And moment of inertia is I only. Now lastly, for the member BD. For the member BD are stiffness of BD, far end is again fixed. Therefore, it is 4EI by L. And moment of inertia of the member BD is also I divided by L is 3 meter. And we can get the total, that is sigma k total summation of the stiffnesses. It will be 3.93 EI. Now lastly, distribution factor. We know distribution factor is the stiffness at that joint divided by total stiffness. That is this one divided by this. You will get distribution factor for the member BA as 0.407. And for the member BC, it is 0.25. And for the member BD, it is 0.34. That is the distribution factors for different members, and it is presented here in this table. Now, this frame has edge support hinge. This should be balanced to zero by carryovering it to the next joint, and we should calculate the modified FEMs because edge support is hinge. If edge support is hinge or roller or overhanging portion, then balancing should be done and carryover should be done, then modified fixed moment. Then we should go for iterations of balancing and carryover. Therefore, this balancing and carryover is mentioned here. That is, MFAB is minus 72, MFBA is plus 48, MFBC is minus 15, MFCB is plus 15. MFBD and DB is 0. Let us not bother about it. Now, as C is hinged, this moment should not exist. Therefore, balance it by adding minus 15. So that moment at C will be 0. And if you balance it, that should be carried to the next far end 50%, that is minus 7.5. Therefore, modified fixed end moment will be minus 72 for AB. No change here. BC, it is plus 48 for BC because it is carried 50%. It is minus 15 and minus 7.5, and it will be minus 2.5. 22.5, and it will be 0. Now, this moment distribution table. It is joint as usual. There are joints A, joint B. For joint B, there are three members connected. If you take member, for A, it is only AB. For B, it is BA, BC, and BD. You can see that portal frame wherein three members are connected. Lastly, joint C. Not lastly, one more joint is there, and D. For joint CA, only one member, it is CB, and for joint D, it is only one member, DB. Now, distribution factor for this, nothing will be there, with a fixed end moment, no distribution at the end. For BA, we have the distribution table 0.41, and for BC, it is 0.25, and for BD, it is 0.34, and for CB and CD also, let us not bother about distribution factor. Now, modified fixed end moments that I have shown in the figure, this, that is minus 72 and plus 48. This one. And here, minus 22.5 and 0. It is minus 22.5 and it is 0. And CB, it is 0 because injured support we got by after balancing. And DB, because there is no loading, that is in the vertical member, it is 0. That is modified FEM. That is 72, 48, 22.5, 0, and for BD and DB, 0, 0. Now, it is balancing. Now, balancing should be done for these three, because joint B, it is 48. That is plus 48, minus 22.5, and it is 0. The net is plus 25.5. The sum of this, it is plus 25.5. Now, balance it means minus 25.5. The difference should be balanced means it is minus 25.5. That minus 25.5 unbalanced moment should be distributed to BA, BC and BD with this distribution factor ratio. That is minus 25.5 into 4.1 into 0.41. It will be 10.46455. I'll take 46. Then 25.5 is distributed to joint BC in the ratio of this 0.25. That is into 0.25. It will be 6.375. That is plus 6.375. I'll take it as 3.8. Then the difference, unbalanced moment, that is 25.5, is distributed to BD in the ratio of this 0.34, that is into 0.34. It will be 8.67. That is 8.67. And this is also, sorry, minus, this also minus, that is 6.38, because 48 minus 22.5 is plus 25.5. Unbalanced moment is plus 25.5 at joint B. That should be balanced, means minus 25.5. That 25.5 is distributed in this distribution factor ratio. Now, it is carryovering. Now, carry over this 10.46 to here by 50% means minus 5.23. This divided by 2. And 8.67. Now, we should be very careful here. Where to carry? That is BC is 6.38. That you cannot carry to C because C is hinged support. There is no moment. But it should be carried to BD by 50%. Now our BD is here. BD or DB. This BD moment, unbalanced moment, should be carried to DB, that is by 50%, that is minus 4.34 we can take. This should be carried to this joint. No carryover moment to the CB because C is hinged. Moment will be zero. I think in this only one iteration is enough, because if you add these two, it will coming the opposite of balancing. Therefore, finally, final end moments. It will be minus 72, minus 5.23. It will be minus 77.23, and here BA it is plus 48 and minus 10.46. It will be, the resulting will be plus 37.55, and this minus 22.5 and minus 6, it will be minus 28.88, and here it is only one, minus 8.67, and here it will be zero because C is injured support and DB is minus 4.34 because it is only one. Now these are the final end moments, and it is presented in this table also. 77.23, 37.55, 28.88, 8.67, 0, and 4.34. That is the final end moments. Now they ask you to draw bending moment and shear force diagram. First we'll go for bending moment diagram with this moments. Now this is the frame. Fixed end. And this is hinged. And here a vertical member. Now to draw bending moment diagram, first we should draw free bending moment or bending moment, simple bending moment diagram, nothing but due to loads, and that should be superimposed with end moments. Now, if you take AB, If you consider Bending Moment Diagram, that is simple Bending Moment Diagram, only due to external load, it is eccentrically loaded. Maximum bending moment for this portion will occur under the load, and its magnitude is W AB by L. That is, here two and 3 meter. That is two here. This will be W, that is 100 into 2, L A into B is 3 divided by L is 5. It will be 20, 40, 120. Kilonewton meter. Coming to the next portion, BC, it is loaded with UDL. Therefore, maximum bending moment by symmetry due to loading will occur at mid-span, and it is WL squared by 8. Therefore, here, it is UDL means it is a parabola. Maximum bending moment at mid-span, and it is W. Intensity of UDL is kN/m. That is 20 into L squared. It is 3 squared. W L squared by 8. That will be 3 squared 9, 180 divided by 8. It is 22.5. Kilonewton meter. Now for this, there is no simple bending moment diagram because no loadings. Now we have to superimpose the bending moment diagram due to end moments, that is finalized in the moment distribution table here. Now at A, AB is minus 77.23. here you mark 77.23 left joint means minus above, and at BA is 37.5, that is right joint means it is above, this is 77.23, this is 37.55, join them. This is 37.55. Now, at same joint, BC, it is minus 28.88. This is the change here, there will be difference. Minus 28 means if you are dealing left from left to right, it is plus. It will be some area 28.88 or 87. Now here it will be 0. This should be joined. To injured support C, that is 0. Now for the portion BD. For BD, we have end moments minus 8.67. That is, if you are proceeding from left to right, if you think you are standing this side, left to right. Minus means it is above 8.67. Now MDB is plus 4, sorry, it is also minus 4.34. Right support, you are progressing from left to right. Therefore, this will be downward because it is minus 4.34. Join this. Yeah. Now the net diagram is this one. Net bending moment diagram after superimposing, it is minus. This portion, it is plus. This portion is minus. Complete this also minus. And this is plus. And this is plus. And this is minus. Is the final bending moment diagram. It is first drawing the simple bending moment diagram that is due to loads. And superimposing the moments due to end moments. That is the net bending moment diagram. Now to draw elastic curve. Okay. Here it is negative, that means hugging, because it is a fixed support. This will not bend for some length because of fixity, and then it starts hugging like this, and it will hug up to this end, this zero bending moment. That means like this. Now, up to here, this is hugging. Now, there is change in the curvature. It sags like this. This is sagging. Now, from ear to ear, it is hugging. Now, convexity upwards. At the same time, it should pass through the joint. That means it is hugging. It is not a straight line like this, hugging. Now from ear to ear, it is sagging. Therefore, it changes its curvature from here, and it will be like this. There will be a rotation as well as slope at this point because it is injured support and it is sagging. That is for the horizontal portion. Coming to the vertical portion, the elastic curve will be, if you take from this end, it is fixed support. Fixed support, it is hugging. Up up to this it is hugging, and here it is sagging. Now it comes like this, sagging. Like this, and then it starts hugging. It remains same like this, hugging, and it is sagging. That is the elastic curve. Now it is shown in PPT also. Here it is shown separately. Okay, this is Venn moment diagram. And elastic curve. Now to draw shear force diagram, we need to calculate the reactions. Now reactions means, again, if you take this, okay, portion AB, that the reaction at this is RA, and reaction at B, RB1, because it is connected to this member also, that is RB2, and here RC. This is with UDL and this is with point load. That is 2 meter and 3 meter. This is 100 kilonewton and this is 20 kilonewton per meter. These are given loading. In addition to this, this is subjected to an anti-clockwise moment, final end moments, that is 77.23. That is here, AB. And BA is plus 37.55. That is plus means here it is clockwise, 37.55. Now this is BC. BC, it is minus 28.88. Here the moment anti-clockwise means here it is minus 28. Not necessary to write minus again, because already it is mentioned as anti-clockwise. And MCB we have calculated as minus 8.67. That is also anti-clockwise. That is MCB, it is anti-clockwise means like this. It is 8.67. Now due to this, and there is another vertical member, that is BD. No external load here, only moments. BD is minus 8.67. That is here, it is clockwise, therefore moment here will be like this, 8.67. And DB is minus 4.34, here also it is like this, 4.33. R3-4, whatever it is, that is the member DB. We'll come to that later. RA, we can calculate, that is by applying sigma Fy is equal to 0 and sigma MA is equal to 0. Sigma Fy means RA and RA plus RB1 will be 100. If you are applying sigma MA equals 0, it is minus 70.23, then plus 100 into 2 minus RB1 into 5, the moment of RB1 here about A, and this is clockwise, plus 37.55. equals 0, and you will get RB1. And similarly, here by applying sigma Fy is equal to 0, RB2 plus RC will be equal to 20 into 3 meters, this is 3 meters, 20 into 3, and from this RA can be calculated. Now RC will be 20 into 3. Now sigma MB is equal to 0, this is anti-clockwise, minus 28.88, then UDL is clockwise, plus 20 into 3 is the UDL equivalent point load into its distance from A, B is 3/2, and minus RC into its perpendicular distance is 3, and this is a moment, it is in anti-clockwise, minus 8.67, that's equal to 0. From this, RC will be equal to, can calculate, back substitute here, you get RB2, and RB will be due to this and due to this. And similarly, for this BD, if you can calculate the reactions by assuming any directions, that is R C dash and R D, only due to moments, they will, you will get in opposite sign convention, and signs should be reversed, and therefore reactions you can calculate like this. And finally, you can draw shear force diagram. RA is plus 67.94, go horizontally up to this no loading, go down by 100 and go horizontally and go up by equal to RB, and here RC is minus, and join that. It is the shear force diagram for the portion ABC. Then for BD, it is 4.33 uniform, here also, and we get plus, and that is the shear force diagram for this problem. Hope you understood. All the things are presented in the table in the slides. You can go through this problem once again. There is so much difference in the analysis of non-sway frame compared to continuous beams. Only the difference is in this joint we should deal carefully. That is, one is in the calculation of stiffness factor, all the three joints meeting at B should consider, and as end edge support is hinged. We are done balancing and concluded to modified FEMs, and then balancing and carry over in the ratio of distribution factor, we'll get the summation, the end moments and simple bending moment diagram. Even though it is not loaded, because of the fixity, there will be end moment, and due to that, bending moment diagram will come. It is only due to the end moment because BD is not loaded, and correspondingly elastic curve. Then reactions, as usual, like in slope deflection method, are some of the problems that we dealt here. Reactions we can calculate, and we can draw shear force diagram. That is the analysis of frame. Okay, go through it once again. Looks like complicated, but once you understand, if you do it patiently, definitely it will be very, very easier than to non-sway frames, very similar to continuous beams. Okay, we will meet in the next class with some more problems. Thank you. Have a good day.